大家好，我是国家京剧院的演员于奎志。
Good evening, this is the master from Beijing Peking Opera Company, Mr. 于奎志。
今天非常高兴，我们国家京剧院一团此次呢，从4月8号从北京出发，到上海、江苏、浙江，进行巡回演出，到访19个城市，巡演23场。历时36天。
We've been traveling around China and to be performance to people, and this is the 23rd cities we've been traveled to, and it's very pleasant to be here.
今天呢，我们是来到了我们江苏的最后一站，江苏的泰州，是一个美丽的城市。
It's a very beautiful city here, Jiangsu, Taizhou, and this is our very last station.
我们所有的演职员呢，来到泰州之后呢，都是感到非常非常的高兴。
All our actors and actresses are very pleased to be here.
因为泰州是我们国家京剧院的首任院长，也是京剧艺术大师梅兰芳先生的故里。
It is the hometown of Mei Lanfang, which is the very first master and the manager of Beijing International Peking Opera Company.
熟悉和喜爱京剧的观众朋友们，大家都知道，梅兰芳大师呢，开创了梅派艺术，也可以说是我们泰州乃至我们中国文化的一张亮丽名片。
Mr. Mei Lanfang, who started the Mei Lanfang School, and it is a very important part of culture in Chinese history.
他所开创的梅兰芳艺术体系，以及他所创建的国家京剧院的艺术风格，至今几代人都在努力地传承着。
The generations has passed on Mei Lanfang School's spirits and his movement.
正好呢，也是在这样一个美丽的这个五月，我们来到了泰州。我们现在就是站在泰州大剧院的舞台上。
We are now at Taizhou the theater and in this very beautiful, fabulous May.
同时，这次呢，我们也是非常荣幸啊，能够有幸来参加中国泰州首届百梅争艳戏曲会的这样一个戏曲盛世活动。
It is very pleasant to be at this place for Mei Lanfang Gala as well.
我们这次带来的呢，就是梅兰芳大师的经典剧目，也是梅兰芳大师的原创剧目《凤还巢》。
Today we're gonna play The Phoenix Return to Its Nest. It was created by Mei Lanfang, and he was very famous for playing it.
现在是晚上的6点钟。其实我们的演职员呢。在4点半的时候，我们就已经来到了泰州大剧院。
Our actors and actresses has been here since 4:30, and they've been practicing here since that.
对，按照我们的京剧演员的职业习惯，我们要提前到剧场进行走台、进行热身、进行训练，为我们今天晚上的演出做好充分的准备。
As Peking opera players, you have to be here at the scene, always practice and get ready for the show.
这次国家京剧院呢，一行接近80人的队伍来到这个泰州来进行表演。
Our crew has over 80 people here, and now we're gonna performance for people tonight.
现在我们国家京剧院下设3个团，1、2、3团。那么这次来的是国家京剧院1团。
We have 3 groups in our National China Peking Opera Company, and today it's our group 1 to be here. We have 3 groups in total.
现在呢，国家京剧院这个所有的演职员，特别是我们的这些演员乐队的这些这个同志，大部分都是80后、90后的青年人。
Most of them are 80s and 90s, and they were very young generations for Peking opera players.
他们绝大部分都是毕业于中国戏曲学院、上海戏曲学院、北京戏曲学院这些专业的戏曲学院。
Most of them are graduates from the professional performance school from Shanghai and Beijing.
通过在国家京剧院在一团的舞台实践当中和通过在日常的训练当中，这些青年人现在都在逐步的崭露头角，都站在了京剧舞台的中央。
They have shown their spirits and their goodness now after they've been acting in the Beijing Opera.
从这些青年京剧演员他们的这种这个进取精神上，可以看出我们京剧艺术薪火相传的希望。
Our new future, our next generation are raising here, and our hope is here for our Peking Opera.
接下来呢，我就是一点一点给大家来进行介绍。现在我们舞台上这些都是我们的各个行当，京剧讲究生旦净丑啊，各个行当的这些演员，他们这个是每天啊，这个几十年如一日，也是京剧几代人都是要这样走过来的一个艰苦的一个艺术过程。
It is our habit and it's what necessary to do for all our characters in Peking Opera to be practiced daily here.
尽管他们都很年轻，但是他们这里头呢，绝大部分啊，这个也都是现在是京剧的一些领军的这个青年人才。
Most of them are already famous for what they're doing now.
也有很多的青年演员都成为了国家一级演员。
And some of them already became number one national ranked artist.
而且这当中有20多位是这个京剧研究生的学历毕业。
Over 20 of them are Peking Opera masters. They have a degree for it.
他们现在每天这个训练呢，我们是这样，就是只要有演出，我们都会提前3个小时到剧场来进行热身训练。
We always warm up 3 hours before the performance in the theater.
如果我们没有演出，我们一般的情况是从早晨9点到晚上5点都在排练场排练。
If we don't have performance, then we would start from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. every day to practice in the practicing room.
我们现在扎着这个大靠的这个就是舞担，它叫戴中宇。
This is 戴中宇 our 舞担。
他是这个优秀的这个青年舞担演员。
He's a very fabulous 舞担 character.
现在他是扎着这个穿的这身是练功靠。
This is for practicing.
脚底下穿的是厚底靴。
And the high boots.
对，你看他的厚底靴都让他都磨破了，练的。
He's been practicing very hard, and he broke the high boots already. Very hard-working girl.
这个靴子有2寸多高。
It's over 2 inches high.
有2寸多高，这一双靴子加在一起至少有接近6斤重。
It's over 3 kilos for this pair of boots.
再加上他这些扎的这个靠旗，在舞台上要跟这个靠旗演员要体现演员的功夫，就是要和他整个这个人形成一体。
It is necessary to have the flag with them, and it is one of the spirit that they work in the same thing.
对，他现在这个练的这出戏就是《大英劫猎》。
It's 大英劫猎 is what she's performance practice with.
对，好，你继续练。她也是研究生毕业。
She's
中国戏曲学院研究生毕业。
Very hardworking girl.
对对对，你看这几个演员，他们现在在这儿，看似好像他们是在坐着，实际上他们是在练卧云儿。
They seems like they are sitting down, but actually they were practicing the way.
对，他们是要就是练这个功夫。
The special performance and singles for their.
看过梅兰芳大师《贵妃醉酒》的这个观众都知道，《贵妃醉酒》里的经典动作之一就是卧云。
It is a signature movement for Mei Lanfang school's play.
对，所以每一个旦角的演员，每一个青衣的演员。都要学这些基本的动作。
Each female players, they have to be familiar with this move.
对，来这边，我们看看我们的乐队哦，在我们还有武生。这是我们的优秀的青年武生啊，郭小磊。
大家好。
他就是江苏人。
He's from Jiangsu as well.
对，你是江苏什么地方？
我是淮安的。
淮安人，淮安人，
淮安江苏。
对，他这个先是就读于这个江苏省艺术学校，然后又考取了中国戏曲学院，在中国戏曲学院作为优秀的毕业生被国家京剧院录用。
He was graduated first in Jiangsu and then he was upgraded in Beijing Opera University. And now he's received by the National Peking Opera Company.
对，去年我们到这个江苏来巡回演出，也到我们首站。去年的8月21号，我们就是在江苏的泰州演出。我们演出《龙凤呈祥》，他就是扮演的大武生赵云。
He was Wu Shen last year when we were here. Last August we were here having a show as well.
对对对，好，你们练，你们先练，哎。来，我给大家介绍一下我们京剧的这个演奏员，也是伴奏员。
This is all the instruments we use for Peking Opera, and this all the musicians for playing them.
现在做的这个我们京剧叫文武场。
It is called 文武场 where we sit here.、哎、
传统京剧基本上就是以这几件乐器啊，这个来构成了这样一个伴奏的这个乐队。
Traditional Peking opera was used and helped by these instruments.
对，这个呢是京胡。
It is small two-string pipe fiddle.
这个就是我们的主奏乐器。
This is we use the most for the whole show.
它就相当于交响音乐当中的小提琴首席。
It was like the violin for the Western countries.
哎，这是魏巍，我们的优秀演奏员。哎
，Our excellent instrument player.
这是京二胡。
This is called 京二胡 and it's a two strings pipe fiddle.
它的声音就已经很浑厚了啊！它起到的作用就是起到一个中音的作用。
It was for the average middle low, the whole sounds.
在我们过去呢，就是我们这个过去的这在这个很多年以前，我们的这个传统艺术，我们的前辈艺术家，这个京剧的乐队伴奏呢，就是用的是京胡和乐琴，这个三弦儿。当时的时候没有这个二胡，这是后来经过这个多少年的时间，也是我们梅兰芳大师啊，把这个京二胡运用到他的这个艺术作品当中。
Years ago, we only use the two strings pipe and this moon look for our shows in the past. And then Mei Lanfang started and involved the Peking Opera instruments with the Jing Er, which is two strings, the bigger ones for it as well.
主要的目的就是为了丰富这个我们的这个音乐的这个色彩。
The level of our music has become more and more rich for it.
我们这是优秀的演奏员庄璇。
This is our instrument's excellent player, Zhuang Xuan.
对，他们都是中国戏曲学院的这个高材生，他也是研究生毕业。
She's a graduate from master as well, and they all very graduate from the Beijing theater, the opera playing school.
而且我们这个团，包括我们这个乐队，都是来自这个祖国的各地啊。
We all come from all over China here, gathered together for our show.
他们是来自中国的最北边，黑龙江佳木斯。
The north place of China, 黑龙江。
他来自黑龙江哈尔滨。
黑龙江 as well from 哈尔滨。
这个是我们的，也是一个主奏乐器，是乐琴。
This is one of the main instruments as well, moon look.
在我们有些这个我们的民族音乐会当中，也能够这个听到这个乐琴的这个它的这个声音。
Some of our traditional music has used a lot as well.
无论是青衣还是老生，就是任何这个文戏的行当，都离不开乐琴。
The male and female characters, when they start playing, we always need to use the moon look.
对对对，这是崔玉坤，是我们国家一级演奏员。
Oh, the number one national national ranked players.
对，他是北京人。
She's from Beijing.
这也是我们国家一级演奏员高霞。 高翔先生。
Number one national ranked players， 高翔。
哎，他这个是这个是三弦。
This is a three string look。
对，这也是我们这个文乐当中啊，会非常重要的一个乐器。
It's very important for our wind characters。
对对对，这是中阮，这是我们的这个也是我们文乐当中的一个主要乐器。
Middle low run。
哎，是起到一个中音的作用。
It was to balance our music。
哎，这也是我们国家一级演奏员裴杰。
The national number one ranked players。
哎，这是马文，我们的优秀的这个演奏员啊，这个是大阮。
Mr.马文 and this is very important play called the large, large medium run.
它主要是起到一个低音的作用。
It is to balance the music as well.
对，都是来为了烘托我们这些主奏的乐器。
They are here, so the main instruments will play and loud and better.
这是我们的青年鼓师王陆宇。
It's our drum, Mr. Wang Luyu.
哎，他是江苏南京人。
He's from 南京，江苏。
对，他现在这个是这个我们叫板鼓。
It is the clapper and the drum together.
对，京剧讲究的这个我们的所有的唱念做打这里面都需要由他来进行这个掌控整个舞台的节奏。
It used a lot for us to give the beat for players, for the actors and actors play.
对，这个是鼓，板鼓。
This called a single skin drum.
对，这个是板鼓，它呢就相当于我们交响乐当中的指挥。
It's more like the instructors for our shows in Western countries.
对，我们所有这些个乐手，所有这些舞台上的节奏，都是看他的节奏来进行演奏。
They all have to play beyond his commendation.
对对对，这个我们是大罗，是我们这个国家京剧院一团优秀的这个演奏员大罗。
Our musician very famous for in our group, and this is a big gong.
哎，这是王立川，他是来自我们的这个辽宁沈阳。
He's from 辽宁沈阳。
对，这个是崔雪松，这是挠脖，放一回头。这是挠脖。
This is the cymbals.
哎，那么这个崔雪松他是来自北京。
Mr. 崔雪松，
我们的优秀的打击乐的演奏员，哎。
Very excellent.
这个谁？这个是这个王这个王超，王超是小锣。哎
，The small gong was played by Wang Chao。
我们传统京剧当中呢，要表现一个水声，说这个演员在舞台上啊，是在这个水上，是在船上，都是靠他们来奏出这个水的声音。你们来奏一下水声。
This is what they do when they try to act the actors was in the water.
哎，所以由他们四位啊构成了京剧的打击乐。
The four of them control all the beats for Peking Opera.
哎，但是我们根据剧目的需要，有些这个剧目文戏武戏不一样，我们要有些大的武戏，像这个长坂坡啊、汉津口啊，包括像一些什么金钱豹啊这样的武戏、闹天宫啊，我们就会使这个小堂鼓还有大堂鼓。这小堂鼓，讲讲。
This is a small hell drum, and sometimes in our special Peking Opera programs, we have to use that.
对，因为我们今天演出的是梅兰芳大师的一个经典的剧目《凤还巢》，所以我们其他的有些个乐器，包括我们的鸣二胡、我们的笙啊，这些都没有用上。其实我们还有唢呐，你看这都还有唢呐，我们在这个戏当中都会有。
It's a wind instrument in this classic Mei Lanfang school show, and we will use this.
对，我们这个京剧的这些演奏员呢，要求的就他们的都是全面的要求，不是单一的就会这一件乐器，他们每个人都会这个唢呐、笛子、堂鼓，这个大堂鼓，这些他们都要能够掌握。
It's very important for our Peking Opera musicians to know at least 2 to 3 instruments to play. They are very excellent and good with playing some different instruments.
对，我们根据剧目，然后我们来再丰富我们其他的乐器，包括笙啊，一些民乐当中的一些乐器，在我们的京剧乐队当中，现在随着时代的发展，我们也在逐步的丰富。
With the evolves in our traditional and nowadays Peking Opera, we were putting all the different instruments to make it sounds better.
对，我们就是力求要给观众啊，这个提供更丰富的、更全面的这样一个音乐的色彩。
It is our purpose to give the audience the best experience for our Peking Opera.
好，那么我们下面我们就请我们这个优秀的青年的演员，他是学习张派。张君秋先生，张派艺术的这个青衣演员刘梦娇。
She is a female,青衣 actress, and she is followed the 张。
对，张君秋。
张君秋 school,
先生。对。
Yeah.
张君秋先生开创的张派艺术。
Mr. Zhang Junqiu is a master for Peking Opera as well, and he started the Zhang Junqiu School as well.
哎，就跟梅兰芳大师的梅派艺术一样，这是也是一个独树一帜的一个流派。
It is one of the classic school for Peking Opera, same as Mei Lanfang School.
对，因为京剧有四大名旦啊，这个梅兰芳啊，程砚秋。啊，这个尚小云、荀慧生，形成四大名旦。但是呢，之后也有张君秋、张派啊这样的这个流派，在这个后来也很多的这个后人们都在学习，都在传唱。
At first, we have only 4 very famous schools for playing Peking Opera, but nowadays they have more and more excellent Peking Opera masters coming out, and nowadays people will follow them as well.
对，好，那你先，你调调嗓子啊，你唱什么？
唱那个状元梅。
状元梅啊，他唱状元梅，唱这个没有，他有话筒。他唱这个《状元梅》呢，是张君秋先生的代表剧目。
It is a classic play for Mr. 张君秋。
这个刘梦娇呢，就是一个她的嗓子非常好啊。这个一个京剧演员需要具备一个，尤其是一个唱功演员，首先要具备一条好嗓子。
They have to have an excellent voice to be a Peking opera player as well.
对，刘梦娇是来自山东济南。
Miss 刘梦娇 is from 山东济南。
啊，现在是国家京剧院一团非常优秀的一个青年旦角。
Our very excellent young generation for playing the female characters.
对，好，那就先我看看下面，你去化妆，你把话筒给他们，话筒给他们啊。还有一个，我们这个你注意看到，就是我们的这些乐手们跟我们其他的这个音乐不一样， 他们的伴奏是不看谱子。
They don't have to see what's going on for them to play.
不看曲谱，对，哎，他们这些演这些，无论是演员唱什么，他都要背下来，要烂熟于心。
They have to get to know what they're playing.
对，好，那么这个现在这个你就站这儿唱就行，这样脸上有面光。这个是我们的这个国家京剧院一团优秀的程派青衣吕耀瑶。
She's 吕耀瑶 from the Chen School.She's very famous.
是京剧四大名旦之一程砚秋先生啊，这个程派艺术的后人。
It's from the Chen Yanqiu School as well, and she's a very excellent next generation.
而且他也师承我们国家京剧院的著名的程派表演艺术家这个张曼玲先生。
And she's learned from Master Zhang Manning.
哎，还有中国戏曲学院的教授陈琦教授。
The professor Chen Qi in the Peking Opera School.
而且他还得到过我们江苏省这个非常著名的前辈程派的艺术家钟荣老师的传授。
And she's learned from our Jiangsu province very famous Chen player as well.
好，你唱一段什么？
锁麟囊。
好，这是程派的经典的代表剧目。
The classic play for the Chen School.
吕耀瑶来自黑龙江哈尔滨。
She's from Harbin, 黑龙江。
这就是程派的这个有程派特色的啊，这样一个流派的唱腔。
This is how they sing with Chen School.
下面叫这个，这是也是梅派的再传弟子李胜素的学生，李胜素团长的学生。
She's learned from Li Shengsu, the very new generation for.
哎，因为胜素团长在化妆。
The master Shengsu, she's doing her makeup now.
哎，她是叫朱红。
Miss Zhu Hong.
是梅派的优秀传人。
Very excellent generations passed down by the Mei Lanfang School.
她是来自辽宁锦州。
She's from Jingzhou, 辽宁。
唱一段什么？
宇宙风。
宇宙风，梅派的经典剧目。
It's 宇宙风 the classic play for Mei Lanfang School.
Thank you. 你通过他们前面这几位的演唱，可以了，你去化妆，去化妆嘛。那个通过前面这个演唱，你就能够看出来我们这个京剧的这种要求，我们的乐队的伴奏员和我们演员之间的这样一个密切的配合。
It needs like we cooperate very close with the instruments players and the singers.
对，就是这个我们的伴奏和演员要形成一个非常默契的这样一个合作关系，就必须要这样的一种训练。
It's necessary for our to practice so we can build the bond.
哎，因为京剧的唱腔很多，京剧的版式也很多，行当也很多。
We have got lots of different characters for singing and characters for playing different shows as well.
所以要求我们这些个演奏员呢，他们就是一定要掌握很多很多的剧目，很多的唱腔。
They have to know and familiar with the most of them.
哎，同时呢，他们不仅仅是在拉曲谱，他还要拉唱腔，要表达的情感，要拉人物的情感。
They have to fill in the emotions into the music when they play the songs.
同时更要拉出每个流派的特色。
And also it's necessary for them to express to us what the school look like.
所以京剧的演奏员绝不这个亚于啊我们那些交响乐的乐手。
They are excellent players and they are top one.
哎，我们的难度大过他们，就是因为他们要照着看着曲谱，他们每个人前面都有谱子。他们前面都没有，他们的前面就是演员。
We have to remember all the songs ourselves and without looking at anything.
对，所以尤其是进入国家京剧院，国家京剧院一团的演奏员，必须是要有具有一个高水平的演奏技术。
It is one of the basic requests for our Peking Opera Company.
哎，这个我们这个花脸演员来了，胡，这是我们的国家一级演员啊，优秀的花脸演员胡斌。
Mr. Hu Bin, he's national number one ranked players for 花脸。
对，他是山东潍坊人。
He's from 潍坊，山东。
对，他是我们京剧艺术大师袁世海先生的这个再传弟子。
He's learned from the master man.
就是第三代传人。
The third generations.
第三代传人。这个袁世海先生和梅兰芳先生当年都同台合作过。
梅世海 and Mei Lanfang, they were performing in the same stage before in the old age.
对对对，他现在是也是我们国家京剧院的这个一团的啊，也是国家京剧院的原派架子花脸的这个领军人物。
He is our very best masters for 花脸。
你这一会儿调一段什么？
那个野猪林。
野猪林是唱这个野猪林，是袁世海大师的代表剧目。
It is a classic show for Mr. 袁世海 classic.
我们的花脸演员都要剃光头。
They have to be bald, shave all the.
对，因为他勾脸，一会儿你到后面我就给你介绍那勾脸，到他勾脸都要勾在这儿，他的脸谱一直要画到这儿。
When they paint their face, the face painting has been all the way up to the head.
一个京剧演员真的是非常非常不容易，我们都是从十岁左右就开始学习，做科学习。
We would start at age 10 to start being a Peking Opera players.
如果你镜头推进的话，你细心的人去看，他们因为从小勒头，他的勒头，他这个地方已经，他这头有一个印儿，看到了吗？
勒头，
常年勒头，都已经都勒出印儿来了。
The times and times ages for them to put the dress up their head and you would see.
对，他的脸要勾到这儿，然后再包上头，这样显得整个的人，因为京剧是一个夸张的艺术，尤其是脸谱是一个夸张的艺术。
To see the out spirit of the Peking Opera, like they have to paint their face very big, so you would show them.
好，你唱吧。
Thank you.
家看到就是他穿的这个也这个化妆服啊，我们叫水衣子，水衣子就是为了擦汗用的。
These clothes were specially is just for the so they can absorb the sweating well.
哎，你看到刚才你都感觉到了，他唱这么一段唱，他这种激情，他已经就是开始就是已经这个完全的投入啊。要是一个大戏下来三个小时，就这个我们叫这个水衣子，这个要换几件，全是汗。
If like you played the whole show for 3 hours, they would have to change these clothes for.Separate of them because they have to use lots of strength to performance.
哎，所以呢，一会儿这会给大家介绍他们这个整个的化妆和穿服装的过程，你就看他在这个外面要穿多少到多少件衣服啊，要很多层。所以作为一个演员，有这么多的灯光，尤其是在夏天的时候，这个八九月份非常热的时候啊，这个演员是很辛苦。嗯、
they have to put many layers on top of these clothes.
好，你把话筒给他，哎。
Difficult for them to play in summer as well.
对，这个再介绍一个，这是老生啊。前面我们有张派青衣，有梅派青衣，有程派青衣，这个又有花脸，这个是老生。
The old male character, 老生。
他是国家京剧院也是非常优秀的文武老生。
文武老生 from our world company.
他不仅仅能唱，他还能这样的翻打。
He's not only can sing, he can dance as well.
他叫刘磊。
Mr. Liu Lei.
啊，他来自河北保定。
He's from 保定，河北。
也是中国戏曲学院优秀的毕业生。
He's graduated in National Peking Opera University as well, excellent player.
我们现在换了个琴师，这个是康长生。
Mr. 康长生 is a musician.
您拿两下这个胡琴。因为京剧呢讲究这个演员跟这个琴师之间这种合作，琴师古师的合作，那么呢他们每个人呢也都有他们的这种专长啊，那么他呢就是更侧重于拉老生。
He is very famous for play the old male 老生's music.
对，康长生也是中国戏曲学院研究生毕业。
He is a master as well.
对，他来自河北这个廊坊。
From 廊坊河北。
你就在这唱吧，唱什么？唱一段《三家店》，儿行千里母担忧。
It's called 三家店 ，and it's to perform like the kids go away and the mother is worried for them.
对对对。这个吊嗓子啊，这个文戏这块呢，我们就先给大家介绍到这儿，然后我们下面介绍我们这个武戏的这些演员啊，让我们这个乐手们也稍微休息一下，然后你们准备这个后面的演出，好吧？你们该练练，该活动活动。好， 现在我们这个京剧演员呢，可以说是这个跟其他的不一样。为什么说京剧它是一个综合艺术？它的唱念做打，尤其这些在打和舞蹈舞的地方，这个舞呢，我们既是包括着舞蹈，也包括着武打。哎，我们的演员不像不，可其实我们是揉的融进了，我们不仅仅是我们的这个音乐唱腔，更多的我们包括我们的武术啊，我们的这些这个技巧啊，这个都在我们这个戏当中，甚至于我们京剧舞台当中还有很多太极的东西都是相互的借鉴啊。这个太极也有我们的东西，我们也有太极的东西。那你像他们这些个武戏的演员，现在这是练功，穿的是练功的这个鞋呀什么。真正到舞台上的时候，我们要勒上头，穿上很多的和厚重的铠甲进行翻打，非常不容易。
When it's actually in the show, they have to put the headdresses on and also like with very high boots as well. And 京剧, Peking Opera, it's a very famous, like with complaining all the different skills into it as well. It's not only sing, it's also with songs, music, and the dance as well. We were fitting Tai Chi and Kung Fu into it as well.
来，我来介绍啊。好，咱们一个一个来，一个一个来，你们就翻一排，随便翻什么都行，捡最保险。来，我介绍一下，头一个，来，这是马敬帅，这是马敬帅，他也是来自河北。
Mr. 马敬帅 ，he's from Hubei as well， 河北 as well。
对，他是我们这个京剧当中的五花脸。
五花脸 in Peking Opera。
哎，花脸有这个文的，以唱为主的，以工价为主的。啊，那么还有以武为主的啊，他就是以武为主的这个花脸。
There were two main characters for 花脸 ，one is for sing and one is for actions。
对对对，你随便，
好，
好的，好的，哎，来，随便来。刘明明，刘明明，
大家好。
他也是来，他也是来自河北，他也是以武为主。
He's from Hubei as well, and he's from Hebei as well, and he's an action player.
对，他们都是中国戏剧学院毕业。
He's all graduates of theater.
因为京剧武这个武戏当中特别需要他们的这种这个表演。
Their performance in the Peking Opera is very important.
很多的外国朋友对我们的京剧的这些武戏啊都非常感兴趣。
People in other countries, they are quite curious about our action moves.
我知道，马上就完，来，马上就完。好，我就不一一介绍了。这是个是这个来自辽宁的啊，这个杨东超唱武上丑的武丑。就是演那个小花脸。
He's the clown and he's from 辽宁。
对。
The male clown。
好，来，李月，这也是来自河北，这也是以武为主啊，他唱武生的，唱武生的。
He can sing and also he's an action player as well。
对，你随便活动活动。王超
，Mr. 王超
也是来自河北保定
，from 保定河北。
下邢台
、
他是这个唱这个也是武丑，唱丑。
He's a clown as well.
对
，character clown.
都行，好。哎，这就是我们这个丑行武丑当中的一个小排头。哎，来，这个是这个魏鹏宇，是我们的这个大武生。
Mr. 魏派玉，
他来自山西
，He's from 山西，
中国戏剧学院的优秀毕业生。好，来一阵，高一阵，这是来自
高
一阵，来自河北，也是
河北雄县，
雄县就现在的雄安。
He's from 雄安，河北。
对对对，他也是唱这个武丑。
He's a clown as well. Clown characters.
好。
所以。 所以老师这个五丑就很好认，就是脸上会有一个花，
对，
一个
很很一个我叫豆腐块一样。
对 so it's very easy to tell the clowns like in the Peking Opera they would have a patch on their face.
所以呢，从这个前面这个简单的一个介绍，你就看出来京剧的演员的非常的不容易啊，他们要日复一日的这个来训练。用这个一些我们的这个俗话说叫台上一分钟台下十年功。
It takes 10 years to practice for them to perform on the stage for 1 minute. It is very important for their and very hardworking for their to practice daily.
好，我们现在到后台去看看这个我们的演员化妆。
We are going to the back scene now to see people doing the makeup.
这个就是刚才在扎着大靠在台上练功的戴中宇。
We saw her was playing for us the first.
好，你换你的。这是我们的老旦演员郭瑶瑶。
Miss 郭瑶瑶 ，and she's played the old female.
今天晚上这个《凤还巢》，她就是演这个夫人。
程夫人。
程夫人。
She's the ladies of the Chen's house.
因为今天晚上的主要演员就是梅兰芳大师这个创编的这个主要的这个角色这个程雪娥，这是她的女儿。
Miss Chen Xue was her daughter, and she is the main character's mom.
就是李胜素回头扮演这个角色，就是她的女儿。她也是我们国家一级演员。
The number one national ranked.
对，他来自我的家乡，我们俩是同乡，辽宁沈阳。
Oh, they were from 辽宁沈阳 together.
你画你的，哎，这个是今天晚上的主要演员。
She is the main character.
陈国森。
Mr. 陈国森 ，So I was, 我看到这个时候，我以为是一个女生，应该是。
她就是女的。
然后是女生是吧？
这个角色是女的。她是演这个程雪燕，今天晚上的这个大小姐。
He's the older daughter of the character.
但是实际上，陈国森先生呢是个男士。
And actually he was a 没有哎，这是我刚才困惑的地方。我说这是个女生，然后发出男生的声音。
因为他扮的呢是这个是一个女这个男扮女装。
He was like a male player, and he's actually acted the woman.
陈国森是我们国家这个国家一级演员
，Number one national ranked players artist。
他是唱丑角儿，是文丑。
And he is playing the clowns as well。
今天晚上他的表演和这个胜素的这个团长演的表演，这个梅派的这个程雪娥呢，他们俩形成一个一美一丑鲜明的对比。
So she.And actually with the other main characters, the second daughter, the younger daughter, they were like, can compare with each other. One is a little bit clowning and one is like prettiest.
今天晚上他们两个演两姐妹。
They were sisters tonight.
你这个镜头推进，你看到他，一会儿你再看到这个胜素老师那个这个扮相，你就还没有演出呢，你就会这个会心的就会笑。
You will tell it clearly later once you see the second daughter, the younger daughter.
对。陈国森先生是北京人
，is from Beijing。
对，我们两个人是同班同学，在中国戏曲学院同班同学。
And he's a classmate with Master Yu。
好，我们现在过那边看看。
剪，
可以了，可以了。我们去看看胜素团长，现在已经开始办了。
We're gonna go see Master Li now.
来了，
好，
这个就是我们梅兰芳大师的再传弟子，这个也是梅葆玖先生的得意高徒，正式的入室弟子，国家京剧院一团的团长李胜素李团长。 你好，你好，大家好。我现在正在准备。小马，你放心，开始扮戏。现在就是扮了一半了。对，这些都是他的这些东西，这些头面。
The headdresses. It's quite a lot.
化妆要化2个小时，要化。因为刚刚从陈国森那儿过来，所以呢，就是你看到这个扮相吗？他们俩像姐俩吗？Clearly
they don't look like sisters.
刚才给我们的翻译都困惑了。那个很幽默的一个姐姐。They took two hours to set all the headdressings，2个小时，2个小时。是的，是的。今天也非常高兴，我们能够回到我师爷。
梅兰芳大师的故里啊，来正好来演这个。梅兰芳大师是他师爷。对对对。She's
the third generation,
第三代。是的，第三代。
She's the third generation of Mei Lanfang school and learned from Mei Lanfang student Mr. Mei Baojiu.
是的，是的。正好今年凤凰巢，你说这个戏多有意义呢。
It is very meaningful for her to play here because this is a hometown of Mei Lanfang, and for her to be here to play Mr. Mei Lanfang's classic show is very pleasant for her.
是。我刚才说了，梅大师不仅仅是泰州的骄傲，是泰州的名片，也是我们中国文化的名片，是世界一颗这个艺术的璀璨明珠。对，我们那个文化伟人的是一代。
The creature Mei Lanfang has been passed down to us. It's become a signature of China to the world as well.
对，所以我们在这个梅大师的家乡，在泰州，在泰州大剧院上演梅大师的经典剧目，每一个演员他的情感都是不一样的。
It's different feelings to our to express today because, like, at the special place, Mei Lanfang's hometown and Mei Lanfang hometown theater to play Mei Lanfang's show, it's a new feeling for us.
所以你看，一个青衣的演员啊，这都是梅兰芳大师他们创造的。他每一个这个装饰头上的装饰，都是这样一点点的装上去。所以要从4点半钟到了剧场之后，他就开始要化妆。
From half full, they will start to put the headdresses on. It takes two hours for them, and each little piece they were individually, and they have to put on separately individually as well.
对，他除了他的脸上的妆和这个两边的这个贴的这个片子是由他自己来做。小马，你来，由他自己来做之后，其他的头饰都是由我们的戎装师马志斌老师。
Miss Marjorie Bing will help her with all the headdresses to put on.
对，马志斌老师是我们国家一级的这个化妆师。First
rank, number one nationality for the makeup putting on, makeup wearing.
对，看似很简单，插上去，但是呢，要求京剧。 一定要很紧，京剧在舞台上不能掉东西，掉东西是大忌。
It's forbidden for you playing Peking Opera and drop the props on your when you're playing, and they have to be put on very tight, wear very tight.
演出过程当中，在舞台上掉一朵花或者掉一个坠儿，这些都是事故，这是国家院团是不允许的。
It is even called accident if you drop props or headdresses on the stage when you're playing.
对。所以我们就勒得很紧，要你看，要从现在要勒上，要到十点半。知道，对，要到将近好几个小时。
It's certainly very tight what they put on their head, what they're wearing, and they have to put on till half ten.
观众看似很漂亮，你看他这个脖子这边勒的这地方，就一直这样吊着。
From the front, it's like excellent and very beautiful, you see. But if you can see down the neck, you will see the wrinkles. It's very tight and hard for them to pull all the up. For show the spirit, they have to pull the eyebrows high to show the spirit.
你看他这个不是画上去的，这个眉毛不是画上去的。 眉毛不是画上去的，是这样吊上去的。
The eyebrow is not actually drawn. It's actually like.
对，因为我们一定要这样吊起眉毛，再一睁， 才有神气。
So, the spiritual outlooking for that, you have to put your eyebrows up.
对对对对。因为今天我是在后半场上，哎，我在后半场我演一个元帅，所以呢，我在前面可以做一些个介绍。一会儿呢，我就开始化妆。开演之前，我要迅速的完成我的装扮。
Mr. Yu would get on the stage for the second half, and he's gonna have to put the makeup on soon as
well. 整个他最后要完成之后呢，他是一个非常的这个漂亮、非常华丽的啊这样一个扮相。
The prettiest woman definitely in this show.全场最聚焦、最漂亮的。
对呀、啊，这就是梅兰芳大师，这个创编的这个戏的这个一个，
也是一个喜庆的戏，
非常特点。哎，这个
团圆戏，
这是一个团圆喜庆的戏。
It is a romantic, comedy.
也是在梅兰芳大师众多的经典艺术作品当中唯一的一出这个喜剧。
It's the only comedy for May School.
对，大家都知道梅兰芳大师创编的《宇宙风》啊，《霸王别姬》啊，《贵妃醉酒》啊。
The other plays Mr. Mei Lanfang created, most of them like they were tragics, like filled with sadness, and this one is the only comedy.
包括《穆桂英挂帅》啊，这都是梅兰芳大师创编的这些这个经典的剧目。
They are classics from Master Mei Lanfang.
但是凤还巢这个戏作为梅派的传人都必须要掌握。
You have to learn how to play the phoenix back to its nest to be a Mei Lanfang's passing down generation.
梅兰芳大师的凤还巢是非常经典的剧目。
It's a very classic play for Peking Opera.
所以呢，这个梅葆玖先生啊，也都传授给了这个李生素这个团长。
Master Li Sheng Su, he can act very well and got all the spirits and movement from that.
他又把他的这些剧目啊，都又传授给了他的学生。
And she been passing down to her next generation as well.
刚才他的学生这个朱红唱了一段这个《宇宙风》。
We saw Miss Zhu Hong before to sing as well. So the Peking Opera is for passing down generation by generation, 一代一代传下。
对对对，
京剧要讲究传帮带。
师承。
师承，传帮带。
It's very important to your.
非常讲究传承。
It's very important and for you to have your own school.
好，我们再到那边去看看那个花脸。哎，他这还得有一段时间。哎，罗森，你没事，你来进来，你跟这个两个人对比一下来，让我们的这些尤其是外国朋友看看。罗森，
好，
姐俩这看看这姐俩怎么样？
好，来，我来站起来，来
站起来，姐俩还没办完，看这姐俩，
还没办完，
长得像吗
？It's the difference between the two sisters.
这边说不好，我们站在这边可能会好一点。这样看，像一对姐妹花吗
？So there are sisters in the show, and now you can tell the totally different.
一个好看，一个丑嘛。
这就是。
他在台上有很好的幽默，很好的这种滑稽的表演。
He's focused on the humor side.
你就说梅兰芳大师有多么的高超，他的这种智慧啊，他的这个对艺术的这种创造力有多么丰富。
His talent for creating the shows to put like different characters into together to display the show.
对，我们留点悬念，一会儿在舞台上。
一会儿台上比我还好，那是
好了。胡子在哪？二，
哎，姜老师呢？
二，这个
画着呢吗？
这个
画着呢。我看看，
画完了一个
啊。胡子，画完了吗？
这是满头的，
你抓紧，没事，我先看这边，一会儿你告诉老师抓紧，一会儿完再接着。
Paris 大红脸。
好，看来开始来了来了，这就开始化妆。哎，来，这是我们的，这是马翔飞。
Mr. 马翔飞。
哎，今天晚上他办这个
程
普，就是这个刚才胜素团长他。他在演他的父亲。
He's the father of the two daughters.
哎，这是我们国家一级演员。
The number one national ranked artist.
非常优秀的老生演员。
Very excellent old male player.
对，这你画你的。哎，这个是，我们国家京剧院的一团的优秀的花脸演员。
Excellent 花脸 players.
哎，他也是袁世海先生、袁世海大师的这个再传弟子，第三代传人。
Third generation for Mr. 袁世海。
哎，今天晚上呢，他扮演的这个角色就是公公，公公。
周坚君。
周坚君。
He is playing the 周坚君。
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 他是湖北武汉人。
He's from 武汉湖北。
也是中国戏曲学院毕业的毕业生。
Very excellent players.
刚才给您介绍的那个胡斌啊，他们两个人是师兄弟。
They will learn together with the other character 胡斌。
我刚才说他们的勾脸，花脸一定要剃光头，勾脸一定要勾到这儿。我说刚才胡斌他们这个头上这都是勒的印儿嘛，他们这都是从小，哎。
They have to like put the makeup on till the top of the head.
哎，所以要想这个从事一个京剧演员，作为一个这职业的京剧演员，就是一定要以舞台、以艺术啊作为这个。第一的这个药物，这个头发，就是你再年轻再漂亮，头发也要剃掉。
You have to shave your hair completely, like if you want to be a 花脸 player for Peking Opera.
一切都要服从这个舞台的人物。
To fit in the character for the stage.
对，京剧本身脸谱也是一门艺术。
The facial article is one of the art and the charming part of Peking Opera.
对，所以呢，这个脸谱，这是其中一个。他们这个花脸演员，每一个花脸演员要掌握至少要上百种脸谱。
They have hundreds different facial paintings for 花脸。
因为中国有五千多年的历史啊，我们的这个历史的故事非常多啊。这个无论是我们的三国呀，我们的水浒啊，有很多的故事里面有很多的人物都是要通过脸谱来进行刻画。
The facial characters, like the facial painting, is very important to show the characters, like their personalities as well. So over the 5,000 years history of China, like you will see, there were over hundreds different types.
哎，这个是我们这个武生，我们的短打武生演员啊，杨欢。
Action player, Mr. Yang Huan.
短打武生就是我们有武生里面分长靠武生和短打武生，有扎大靠的，啊，有的是短打，他是短打武生。
There were two types like action player 武生 in the Peking Opera. Some of them has flag on the back, and some of them dress without flag.
哎，他是来自辽宁锦州。
He's from 锦州，辽宁。
哎，刚才那个周坚君那是勾的是花脸，他扮的这是我们叫俊脸，就是这个英俊的俊，俊脸，
俊脸，
俊
handsome face，
哎
，it's a handsome character。
介绍一下姜老师。好，
好，他们刚才在练功，这会儿有的演员就已经开始化完妆了，化完妆了。
对。
对。胡子，你就坐在我那儿。你坐在我那儿。小生，哎，他这个木居易男主角，今天晚上他是哎主演，好，对，待着，你们起来，把那。 给您介绍呢，哎，咱翻译在这儿啊。这个是我们今天晚上的男主演
，the major character，
是我们国家一级演员，也是这个我们的京剧啊叶派小生创始人叶盛兰先生的再传弟子。
Master Ye Sheng Lan School is the third generation, and he is the national number one ranked player artist.
江奇虎
Mr.
江奇虎先生
Master 江奇虎，
他是中国目前小生这个行当当中的领军人物。
He's number one ranked in 小生 player.
哎，是我的师弟。
And they were learned from the same master.
而且他是江苏人，江苏淮安人。
It's from 淮安，江苏 as well.
你自己介绍介绍今天晚上你这个角色。
非常高兴来到我的家乡，也是梅大师的故里来演出。今天呢，我饰演的角色叫莫居易，非常非常的荣幸，而且带着一颗敬畏的心到泰州来演出。因为是梅大师的家乡，能够，
让他
翻译，对不起啊，
没事。It's very pleasant to be here, and it's very tough for me to play here because, like, it's a hometown for Mei Lanfang.
这个到梅大师故乡来演出啊，但是真是带着一颗敬畏梅派艺术的心来演出的。
I'm flattered to be here to play Mr. Mei Lanfang's show.
每一个团员到泰州来，其实我们都是来朝圣来
的。It's not only come here to play. We owe the Bibles for Mr. Mei Lanfang.
我们内行说，今天非常高兴能够傍着梅派梅大师的再传弟子，已是第三代的传人，梅派的表演艺术家李胜素来演出今天《凤还巢》，也是我非常高兴的事儿。我们合作多年。
He's been like a play Peking Opera a lot and several years, and they've been team with Master Li Shengsu as well for ages, and they are all very flattered to play the Peking Opera in here.
我的未婚夫。
对，
今天
舞台上的未婚夫。
They will play like the married couples in the show.
我们在舞台上也塑造夫妻的形象，也塑造兄妹的形象，有很多种啊，这种在舞台上的合作。
They are in a very good band for playing. Like they were playing the boyfriend girlfriend together, and also like sometimes they were in the show playing brother and sisters.
今天能够有现代化的手段来传播咱们京剧，对京剧来说也是一个幸事。但是我个人认为。京剧是剧场艺术，还是希望广大观众走进剧场。
It's very important, like, and it's necessary, and I'm very happy. Like nowadays, we can all use all the different equipment for people to get to know Peking Opera more. And also, but I think, like, for personally, it's important to come into the theater to watch yourself personally here.
会有不同的感受。
You will feel totally different.
有很多的这个国外的通过这个平台让向国外的传播我们的中国文化非常好，让了解中国的传统文化。
It's very good way for people in other countries can know our China, to know our Chinese culture. It's a very, very nice way and to show people what we got here.
我们这次呢，就是这次巡演啊，我们是在上海啊，这个举行了一次台前幕后的啊，向这个全球的观众啊介绍我们这些京剧的这些特色，在上海这个搞了这么一次，后来我们又到了江苏的兴化啊，我们因为带来的有不同的剧目啊，不同的风格，所以我们在兴化搞了一次。那么今天这是第三次，我们在向我们的这个海内外的观众来介绍我们的京剧。
We started our first step in Shanghai to show the international, like people, like how Peking Opera stage, the backstage, the scene, like, and then the second, we went to Xinhua, and this is the last station for us, last stop for us to here to play, to display, to show people all around the world our cultures and the scene behind the. the scenes, the preparations before the Peking Opera performance.
我们国家京剧院一团在过去的几十年的这个艺术这个发展过程当中啊，到访了几十个国家。
We've been traveling and played in many countries over last decades.
啊，同时呢，我们是这个国家京剧院一团，如果没有这个疫情的这个影响啊，我们去年是应该是第七次到访英国。
We were going to visit England to play there last year, but we all know as the coronavirus going on, we couldn't start the trip.
而且我们是每一年都到港澳台地区进行演出。
Every year we would go to Hong Kong, Macau, and Taiwan to do the performing as well.
国家京剧院一团连续22年到宝岛台湾演出。
We've been to Taiwan for last 22 years in a row, non-stop.
对，连续16年到香港去参加香港艺术节和香港中国戏曲节。
Been to Hong Kong for the last 16 years to be there at their galas.
啊，而且我们是近几年每年都在澳门回归祖国的时候，在这个纪念日的时候，我们都会去到澳门演出。
Every anniversary from Macau back to China, we would go to Macau to do the performing.
今年的12月份，我们还会再到澳门演出。
We would have been to Macau again this year, December.
盛素团长在英国演出的《白蛇传》在英国的主流媒体获得了5星级的评价。
Master Shen Su, she has 5 stars highly recommended when she played the White Snake in England.
那次也是让我们第一次感受到了英伦三岛的观众对于中国传统艺术的这份热爱。
It's actually the first time we felt the people overseas their passions for Peking Opera.
啊，英国的观众热情地把很多的这个鲜花扔到了舞台的这个地毯上。
They tossed lots of flowers onto the stage to show their respect.
所以至今给我们的演员都留下了一个非常美好的印象。
It's a very nice experience for us.
对，包括法国、澳大利亚、英国的演出，令我们都非常难忘。
It's very nice memories for us for being to France, Australia, and all the countries.
我们也特别希望我们这个疫情能够早一点过去，我们能够再次的走出国门，向世界来推广我们的京剧艺术。
We hope the coronavirus would end soon, so we can go to your countries to perform on the stage for you.
好，那我们可以准备了。
好，你们开始准备。
你主持的这么好、
啊，没
翻译的也好，
我是有感而发，主要是翻译的好。走，嗯。我们现在去看看这个演员的穿服装勒头，已经进入到这个最后的这个完成的阶段。
We will see the actress for their headdress.
在这边啊，走来这边，哎，快点来，哎，好，开始穿，谁再穿，开始来，来，那走，好，好，我呢是这样，我来给您介绍，现在我们演员呢，这个区域是我们的盔箱，这个区域，这都是我们的盔箱。啊，回头。
These are the props for the show.
对，那边是我们的服装。
So all the costumes over there as well.
啊，因为我呢现在马上要去化妆，我呢现在就委托我们国家京剧院的这个优秀的青年花脸演员刘葵葵。
Mr. Liu Kuikui is a very excellent player for 花脸。
哎，他也是国家一级演员。
The number one ranked national actress.
而且是这个，也是袁世海大师的第三代传人。
The third generation of Master 袁世海。
哎，我们国家京剧院一团有3个原派的继承人。
We have three different. We have three people. They were passing down the studied the 袁世海 袁世海 school.
哎，那么前面演唱的那个胡斌。和刚才勾这个周坚军红脸的这个魏家庆，啊，再加上他，你从这个发型上就看出来了。
You will tell the difference just to see their head, like they were without hairs.
对，他也是来自我的家乡辽宁沈阳。
is from Shenyang, Liaoning.
哎，我让那个刘葵葵呢来负责给您介绍一下我们这些服装啊、徽章啊，他要了解一些，然后啊什么这些，包括他们的穿戴，好吧？
好。
然后我去化妆，一会儿我再和来和咱们大家一起互动，好吧？
好。
Master Yu has to go put makeup on now. So.
好。好，那么于老师去化妆啊，由我来为大家接着介绍我们的这个后台的一些内容啊。这个首先呢，这位老师是我们的徽箱老师，负责勒头的，站着这个啊。
He is for putting the hairs for people。
因为在舞台上，每个演员不同的人物、不同的身份，他头上戴的头饰呢都是不一样的。
Different characters, they have to put different stuff on their head, wear different makeups as well.
咱们离近点啊。现在呢，这位是刚才介绍了，是马翔飞，马翔飞老师唱老生。
Mr. 马翔飞。
你看他这是里头这道啊，里头这道我们就叫网子啊，网子呢是负责把眉毛吊起来。
This is a net, Master. You were talking about for put the eyebrow up.
哎，对，显得人非常精神啊。
Like to see the spiritual outlook.
哎，完了，一般这个工序就是这个勒完网子勒包头，就是叫水纱。勒完水纱之后呢，就穿服装，穿外衣，最后勒最外头的那个帽子。
It will just lift the eyebrow out up first, and then put the net on, and then like we will put the very outside headdress on after.
好，先让他勒，咱们往这儿看啊，往这儿看。这是今天我们这个演这出戏所需要用的，演员需要用、人物需要用的头上戴的头饰啊。
This is what they wear today for the show.
等会儿勒头，这第一个啊，这叫帅盔，元帅戴的。
This is for the general.
哎，就是刚才一会儿于老师要戴的，他在里边演一个元帅。
Master Yu would have to put this on later in a bit.
这个叫荷叶盔，它的上面像一个荷叶包着一样，完了是那个刚才勾脸那个花脸谱那个花脸戴的。
Xueyan character would put this on, like it look like the lotus flower on top.
啊，还有这个三个都是纱帽，纱帽官员戴的。
The official like workers in the old past they would wear these.
哎，这个咱们平时说话也能提到乌纱帽。
Yes, for people working for
the government. 头上的乌纱帽，
people working for the
就是这个东西。
Government.
哎，对对。
Official look.
这个是这个小生的这个学士巾，是一会儿江启虎老师那个小生要戴的。
Master 江启虎 would have to wear this later.
哎，对。
It's for the young male.
嗯，
年轻的。
哎，对对对，年轻的。
能介绍
这底下这一排呢是胡子，胡子。
This all the beard they have to wear.
我们这个行话啊，我们这个行里头叫染口，染口啊。
All the beard they all shows different ages. 您能介绍一下，就是这大概是哪个年龄？
我知道。它不同的颜色象征不同年龄，还有行当不一样，要戴不一样的染口啊。
The different jobs and different ages have to wear different beard.
你比如说这个，这些都是，这叫黑三。因为它分三绺，一中间一绺，这边两绺，黑三。
These black ones they actually have three parts, one, two, three, three layers.
主要是老生，老生戴。
The old male would have to wear these.
你再看这个，稍微黑白相间了，就到了中年，五十多岁了。
About age 50, they would wear this one. It's like 40 to 50, the gray beard.
你叫惨三，你像这个就是白颜色了，就是老头了。
The old male would have to wear the white one. Over 60s, 六十岁像是。
介绍完了，完了之后呢，还有今天这个戏呢，就这么些胡子，还有别的戏，还有很多。不同样式的胡子，还有红色的。
They even have red beard, like they have so many different types of beard. Purple beard as well.
都有。 但是今天呢就展示这么多。
For our show, like we only have this types of beer, but there were so many different types of beer in other shows.
哎，这就是我们的盔箱，盔箱的部分。哎，咱们往服装这走啊。
I'm gonna see the costume now.
看这位马祥飞，马祥飞老师已经办好了啊。哎，还有这位。这个介绍一下，刚才这是丑行演员，我们一团的这个青年当中的主力军啊，非常这个在舞台上非常成熟啊，他演今天演的呢是这个朱焕然朱千岁，就是跟这个戏是明朝的戏嘛，他跟这个老朱家他们是亲戚，所以他是属于这个皇家的皇亲国戚。你看他穿的一身黄，这平民百姓是不许穿黄的，你知道吗？只有他敢穿。
The normal people like they come not allowed, forbidden for them to wear yellow. Only the people to do with the royal family they can wear yellow. So in this show, in this display, he's actually one of the royal family.
他。扮演丑行呢，这个在今天这个在舞台上，他的戏份也很重啊，是有很精彩的、非常滑稽幽默的表演。
He has lots of like funny actions in this show to be show as a clown, 丑是吗？
哎，丑。
The clowns, they all have a white patch on the in the middle of their face.
对，他脸上勾一个我们叫豆腐块啊，就是丑行。
Like a piece of tofu on the middle of the face.
好，让演员先准备，咱们看看这个服装啊。这是我们就是演出的平时演出的服装，这个整个我们叫大衣箱，就是主要是这些比较华丽的服装啊。这个服装呢分颜色，也分图案，也分款式，不同的颜色、不同图案、不同的款式呢就是象征的身份或者是场合。你像这件叫蟒袍啊。
The different colors and styles of clothes shows your position in this play.
蟒袍为什么叫蟒呢？这个绣着，这个五爪的是龙，六爪的是蟒。但是呢，现在呢，这个就都是绣的龙了啊，就没有这么严谨的要求。但是那叫蟒袍，它是红颜色，是元帅穿的。
It's red. It's from the general, and it has like a dragon in the middle to show like his power.
好，这个后边这个啊，再看一下，后边这个玉带啊，这是带呢，我给它拆开啊。
The bill.
好，其实你转过来，挂上吧，把它转过来，拿着这个。这个在舞台上是什么样的啊？舞台上这个人，这个带是这样的，看着啊，这个人上台要端着带。
You have to carry the belt when you're walking on the stage.
这是一种戏曲，这个把这个服装夸张了。在生活当中，过去的古代，这个带是修身的。
In the real life, it's actually like a fit to your clothes, but as the stage performance, we enlarge it.
在舞台上给他写意了，为什么呢？演员出来要端着带，显得这个人比较庄重，端架子嘛，就是在舞台上比较美观，也比较庄严啊。
It's just to show the people's characters like personality and their strong powers when they come out with the belt in their hand.
哎，这就是蟒啊。好，当然了，还有不同颜色的蟒啊，今天不一一介绍了，有黑的，有绿的，还有时候皇上也穿红的，也穿黄的啊，黄就是绣着龙啊，底下这海水江崖，像水一样啊。
This is like the water.、
哎、因为这有龙嘛，龙离不开水嘛，啊，这是陪衬。
The dragon has to stay with the water, so it's always like the style like that. But with
手一针一针的绣上。
对，这个是手绣，是手工绣的金线。就是纯手工人工绣的。
It's all sealed by hand, like.
哎。
Sealed by hand.
还这是，这是介绍一下这个。你看看，这是披呀、啊，有靴子吗？这衬靴哈、啊。嗯。这一件叫，哎。哦，这行好，这个老旦老师正在穿服装。啊，这位是服装老师，叫于洋啊。 你这是老旦的颜色，你给介绍介绍啊。
这个就是叫香色，
香色的，就是香色的，
对，叫香色的坯。然后一般就是香色是用于这种老旦或者老生，就岁数比较年龄比较大的，
半黄半绿叫香色。
This color like we think like between green and yellow is more for the people with like older females。
啊，对对对。
他跟那个祥飞哥是
对，刚才他那个老生
是一对的，一样的，
对
对
对，
对
一家。
像这种衣服就属于在家穿的这种居家的那种衣服嘛，是吧？
对，
居家服。
House wearing clothes，
大户人家，
比较有钱的
啊，比较有钱。
From wealthy family like rich family。
那边绣的很多啊图案，所以就是比较华丽一点啊。
后面家里变穷的
啊，对，后面这个戏根据戏的发展，他就穿一个素的，因为家里穷了，就是这样。
The clothes also can show the people's wares like.
一会儿再过去，不是啊。好，我们往这儿走。米阳还有什么衣服？你看看建议，还有靴子或者是啊。这是一件建议啊。好，我们介绍一件这件。这件叫箭衣，弓箭的箭。
The arrow outfit.
这个，我们。京剧的服装都是沿用明朝，有部分清朝服装的款式来延续下来的。
Most of them all follow the Ming Dynasty styles。
你看，这是建议，这张老师要穿服装了。
No。
这是建议，这是马蹄袖，这个是你看这个，现在你还看清朝人有时候骑马射箭的时候，就穿这种。
So it's for you, on the horse, ride the horse and try to use the arrows.
哎，你看他也绣着龙，就是一定是很有身份的人才能穿这种绣龙的箭衣啊。
The people wear the clothes with dragons.
哎，对，或者是皇上，或者是王爷。
哎、Either like the emperor or the brothers of the emperor.
哎、对，看看这个。这是一件靴子啊，我们叫靴子，就是休闲装。
休闲装 ，it's like a casual wearing。
但是这个是小生穿的啊，绣的竹子。
For the young male。
哎，对，它绣竹子代表这个宁折不弯，就是一种品质吧。啊、
the bamboo on it actually shows the character's。Spirit as well to show like they wouldn't bend their wills.
哎，这个就是平时这个行路的时候这种啊，比较穿着比较舒服的一种衣服啊。
Normally when they take a walking or things like they will wear clothes like this.
还说一个题外话，这种衣服的款式呢，其实是从哪儿来的？从那个。道观的老道的服装是演变来的，我们也叫道袍，但是道袍呢是纯黑色，你知道吧？它这就绣上活。你看这个款式，你除了没有这个水袖，这白的就叫水袖。
嗯，水袖 ，water sleeve。
哎，这是手袖子的延伸，为了更好的在舞台上舞蹈。
嗯嗯 ，it's for to performing better.
水袖一定要白。
White color, they have to be white, and this is the style of the doll that the.Doll culture.
其实还有不同颜色、不同花色都有啊，不同行当穿的都有。
Filled with all the different colors.
嗯，你看姜老师现在要穿的这件就是黑色的靴子。
You're gonna wear the black one now.
他这个脖子领子上绣的是梅花，看见没？
The blossom.
也是一种有寓意，梅花香自苦寒来嘛。
The plum, the flower.
它这个黑色呢，证明它现在的生活比较窘迫。
The black the color of the clothes actually shows like he's kind of like in a poor situation, like he's not very wealthy.
哎，等演到后边他转运气来了，转运了，
and
也升官了，就穿不一样的衣服。
When he get a bit lucky and he will change to other.Colors of like.
这个时候还是一个书生。
You're only a student now.
哎，对对对。现在，这个老师是给我们穿服装的老师，叫傅天威老师啊。
Mr. 傅天威 is like especially for.
这是非常辛苦啊。
Hard working.
给每个演员穿服装，不同的人物他都得记着穿什么。
He has to remember thousands of like different characters and to put clothes on for them.
嗯，这个演员是个小丫鬟，扮演是小丫鬟。这个。
This is a servant for the family.
你看他穿身上穿的是个坎肩儿，看到吗？啊。
The vest.
年龄比较小，大概在十六七吧。
About
十三四十六。
Age of 16 or 17.
哦，好。行，咱们现在要这边大概看一看啊，
嗯、
简单的介绍，这离远看照一点，因为这现在过去吗？啊，这边就叫三姨啊，三姨就是里边穿的，比如说彩裤啊。还有护领啊
啊，
照在穿在里边的啊，
还有
水衣子啊，不用太近啊。好，走吧。好，咱们上侧台看看，演出开始了。
Show started now. Now we're gonna take you to see the show.
This is our sound engineer, Qin Ying.
Sound engineer.
This is a very important job. Because the actors of the stage have different characters. When they go up, every person has to push it up. When they go down, they have to pull it down. The actors have to talk in the back. They have to communicate.
He's like a key point for people entering and exit the stage.
So it's very...
Pay fully attention. Pay fully attention to the whole show.
好，这是演出开始了。你看这道幕啊，照这道蓝色的，这是我们叫二道幕。投了最外边那个红色的叫一道幕，就是演出正式开始。啊，这就拉头一道幕，正式演出开始。中间再拉这个二道幕，拉和关。是为了换场景。
Every scenery changing, we would see through the blue curtain. Every time, once the red curtain opens, that means the show started. But every time you change the scenery, you will see till by the blue curtain.
换场景，比如说这现在是在郊外，一会儿再一拉幕再开开，就回到这个员外家了。
Now it's actually like in the countryside, and later, like once they close and open again, we would be at his house.
这个二幕呢，在过去的京剧舞台上是没有，后来人家为了净化舞台给加上了。过去这些台上摆这些景啊，都直接上人去给他抬下来，但就这种容易破坏画面。
也是因为过去那个舞台是比较小的，对吗？
对，比它舞台比较小。第一舞台比较小，第二确实也没有这个幕。
那个展现的更好。
对，这个就是干净，舞台就是画面更干净了。把幕拉上，人才上，把它抬下来。
So in the past, like they don't really have the blue curtain to show you the scenery changing, but it's also to do like in the past the stage was kind of small, but nowadays like as we have bigger stage and for show you like without people moving all the props, so we use the blue curtain to make the show nicer.
你看现在就是非常立体的展现了，演员穿上衣服了，拿上道具了。这边乐队呢也开始就是合奏了，这是正式的演出，就是这样。现在就是表现场景是这个穿黄衣服呢是朱千岁跟这个程普，他俩是好朋友，在郊外喝酒，偶遇成这个书生了。
So the two old friends, they were drinking together in the countryside, like in nowadays we say having a barbecue outside, having a picnic outside. This is saying like they meet the major character.
你看这个朱千岁这个丑行人，他旁边站了俩人，是他的随从， 但这个俩人呢也能代表四个人或者是很多人，就是证明他家业大，好摆谱，摆排场，讲排场。
On this show, we can see there are two characters wearing black next to the. They are also painted the clown face, but in the Peking Opera, it's not only present for two people. They could present for four people as well. It's just fine for us to see and to tell, like to present. He's like has from a very rich family, has lots of servants.
真厉害。这个书生呢的父亲呢跟这个现在这个老员外啊是一个退休的国家官员，兵部侍郎，退了下野了，完了这个小生江继国老师扮演的小生的父亲跟他是同僚，但是他父亲已经死了，被奸臣害死了，但他俩不认识，
然后就家道中落了。
哎，完了这回认识了之后，这个老员外就想招他当那个女婿，就是这么个戏。
So the guy say the people he's in green, like he's like he once was a colleague with the student's father, and after the student's father died, they haven't seen each other for ages. Now.They popped like in the picnic, and he's very, very like him, and he thinks like want him to be his daughter, a son-in-law.
你看那个两边站着那两个人，有一个人身后背了一个马鞭啊，我们叫马鞭，他在舞台上就象征着马。一会儿这是给朱千岁骑的一匹马，他要是拿上了就是骑上马了。
You would see like the bloke in black, he has a horse whip behind him. It's actually presented as a horse on the stage. Once the Mr. Zhu had it in his hand, that means he's on the horse, he's riding the horse.
这个马鞭呢的颜色呢也是一样，就是有寓意，比如说这是一个橙黄色的马鞭。一般是皇家人骑或者是王爷、才能骑那么黄色的马。
So the orange horse reaper is just for the people, the royal family.
长者在上，学生有礼。
两公少爷见过千岁。
这位
尊称。
咱们。咱们看看，今天的主演，我们这个李生素团长现在准备扮戏，穿服装了。咱们来看一看。
李生素 gonna put her outfit on。
大师。
大师。扮一个未出阁的千金小姐，没出阁的。
She's still
贱闺秀。
She's the favorite girl of Chen Pu, and she's a younger sister, unmarried girl.
绣这个图案就证明家里比较殷实啊。
The bright color is more for girls from a rich family and not get married. The single girls, the miss.
漂亮吗？
漂亮。The prettiest girl in the whole show.
我先去后场。后场。 刚才看他的手非常白，他要是我们叫眼手，拿白粉上眼，上台灯光一照显得更白。
They have to put like a white powder on the hand as well to show like the family wills and as well.
这是一般主要是这个旦角要有这下子。
Most used for the dan female players.
旦行对要再往前走啊。现在在喝水，我们叫印场，这是行话，印场，饮水的饮，印场。
上台之前，
上台之前或者下来，都有一个。
Like before get on the stage and get off, after get off the stage, they would have a drink first, a sip of water first.
对，那两个是他学生，但是过去呢，在过去戏班那有专业的，就是干这行的，当角的，专门负责给递水的。
In the past, they have the people specially just for offering them waters, but nowadays they don't have the role anymore.
翻译的好啊，翻译的非常好。这个有意思，现在都用杯子，你看在旧社会都用壶，它壶啊，它有壶嘴，就对嘴，这样还不容易把这个嘴唇上的口红给蹭了。
Nowadays we use a cup, but in the past they have to use a pot, as the pot like the top is very small, so when you actually drink it, it wouldn't ruin your makeup.
好，咱们往前走，也主演准备上场，咱们体会体会啊。
I would see the major character play.
这还有一会儿，你们小点声。这个一般，这个比如说这场戏的主要演员要出场，观众会有一个碰头号，就他一出来，一定会叫一声，因为这是来看他来了嘛。一会儿咱们看看啊，现场体会一下。
Once the major character get on the stage, as the major character in the stage for this show, like normally the audience will clap straight away once they get on the stage.
饮酒操持一将女，不是心里病女。
上台一人念一句，我们叫念对儿，像诗一样上下句儿。把这个演员的或者是身份，或者是他在做着什么事儿，或者他现在一个什么状态，简单的就一个介绍一下，就这么个意思。
Once they got on the stage, they will have short sentence to show what they are about to do or show their identities.
哪里去了？是啊，车祸丫头往哪里去了？
一会儿等那个咱们看这个二小姐该上了啊，二小姐上了。
这不是大小姐
吗？大小姐在上。
The older sister is good on the stage now.
不读诗书，
他也那一对儿，不读诗书懒刺绣，就介绍自己，就愿意玩。
It's like an introducement for himself, introduction for himself, for herself, like the short, during the short sentence.
这就叫自我介绍啊。
其实我也想着他们
不
咱们现在就是先看一看演员的演出，一会儿介绍一下这个道具。那么最后呢，由于老师化好妆来这个做结尾，
做个结束语。然后下一站是杭州余杭，是吗？
啊，对。
嗯，好，行。
下场，下场。
一个水袖。姐姐最后是嫁给了那个朱仙岁吗？
对，阴差阳错了、所以这个戏非常有戏剧性，都是巧合，但是就是
这个是这种爱情喜剧的好幼稚的，但是他在过去把这样的情节给刨出来了。
像天注定一样啊，算来算去，轮算不如天算。这场完了吧？
马上完了，
完了，咱们就介绍一下
这场完吧。
这场
完了，过去于老板正好穿服装，穿服装了一头。
哦，
然后
这样就行了，
不用
事，
那就照于老板，直接就是到那个穿。
好。
会按到什么频道吧。把那个小
孩
我看环境大了。
正好我要去化妆了，正好于老师也这个化完妆了，现在准备穿服装，我们还是把话筒交给他，他再为大家介绍。
给翻译拿着就可以，翻译拿着就行。我穿服装，我利用最快的速度，这个完成了我的这个化妆。刚才这个是我们的这个一级演员优秀的花脸啊，这个刘葵葵给大家介绍了我们这个幕后啊。这些服装啊、戎装啊、道具啊、音响啊，大家也在这个侧台啊，也看到了嘛。我们已经开演之后啊，舞台上的这些呈现的一个面貌。
Mr. Yu has showed us the backstage, and we've been seeing the performance from the side of the scene.
啊，因为呢，一方面是我们呢，我从艺了50年。所以这个应当说是舞台经验还是有一些，所以我的化妆呢会利用最快的速度去完成。
Master Yu has been Peking Opera for 50 years now, and he can now use the quickest time to finish all his makeup.
对，我今天呢是在这个戏当中呢，我扮演的是元帅。
He was a general's show.
元帅洪公。
Mr. Hong. The general.
所以呢，刚才在前面这个一个多小时给大家这个介绍过程当中啊，大家已经感受到了我们京剧艺术的博大精深。
We must already feel like Peking Opera has lots of things in there.
我们后台这些个服装师，我们的这个盔箱师，我们的这个道具师，包括我们的音响、灯光这些，他们都是要这个从小。开始这个进行学习和训练，都是进行一些专业的训练。
The people at the backstage for the sound assistant and the costumes, they all trained since they were little. They was just special for Peking Opera.
而且有很多的这些都是梨园世家一代一代的传承下来的。
They all the symbols for the Li Pier Garden, Pier Garden.
所以京剧是一个综合的艺术，大家观众在舞台下看到演员在舞台上这些精彩的表演，有很多都是我们幕后的这些我们叫幕后英雄，啊，这些部门服化道这个化这些这个部门呢，这些个老师他们付出心血来进行完成的。
The perfect performance you see, the audience can see, it's count like the contributions of the people from the backstage, like can't ignore them, like they contribute lots to the whole show.
你像我们昨天晚上还在南京演出，今天早晨我们全团啊，这个坐着长途汽车啊，接近三个小时来到泰州。
Last night we were still in Nanjing, and this morning we came to Taizhou with a bus, with a 3 hours journey.
我们的演员可以这个稍事休息，但是我们的这个前后台的舞台工作人员，他们一刻都不能停，他们要马上进行装台。
The actor and actress they could have a relax for a bit, but all the people for preparing all the backstage they actually can't relax. They have to get everything settled immediately.
对于国家院团啊，国家级的京剧院团的这些舞台工作人员，用我们的话说，应当是一个半军事化的这样一个工作作风。
It is half military like management for them to solve all these.Costumes and props.
因为我四点半钟，我的全体演员就要到位。
All the staff has to be here attempt at 4:30 p.m.
我们这十几个舞台工作人员要在我演员四点半到位之前，要完成所有这些东西的出箱，服装的出箱熨烫。
And they have to get everything prepared before 4:30.
灯光的调试。
The lights adjusting.
音响的调试
，sounds of system，
盔箱所有这些东西的这个摆放，
and all the props and costumes has to be organized，
包括道具布景
，the scenery as well，
都要就位
，they have to put it to the right place。
三个小时演出结束之后，他们马上就要装箱。
And after the show, they're gonna have to put everything back.
然后装车。
And put back into the car.
装上集装车之后，今天晚上连夜就要奔浙江。
And then they will head to Zhejiang province straight away tonight.
我们明天全团就要转赴浙江的杭州余杭进行演出。
And they would performance in Yuhang, Zhejiang tomorrow.
所以作为一个国家的院团，不仅仅在舞台上要体现出要展现出京剧艺术的魅力，给观众带来艺术的享受，同时我们整个对团队的管理也都是要非常非常的严格。
As a national Peking Opera company, like it's not only like we perform on the stage, the management is also very important during the whole team, for the whole team.
所以我们无论是演员伴奏还是我们的舞台工作人员，大家都要在这个同一个啊这个工作的状态上来进行工作。
We have to in the same pace for our play actor actress and actors, also our musicians and people working in all the different jobs. We have to work as a team tightly.
每一个人每一个部门每一个环节都不能有丝毫的大意和疏忽。
No mistake is acceptable.
用我们这个行话啊，说是这个戏比天大，就是艺术是我们的生命。
We respect the artist and it's the most important thing to us.
尤其是现在党和国家对于传统文化的弘扬和扶持加大了力度。
The China is actually like very supporting the traditional operas.
大力提倡传统艺术的发扬。
We really wanted to show our traditional like cultures to you.
所以国家京剧院一团就必须要这个走在这个前列。
and we are the soldiers for it, and we have to work hardest and be there to show people, to guide people how to do them.
不仅仅在艺术上、作品上，要具有这个代表性、示范性和这个引领性，同时我们的整个的这个团队的作风也要具备这样一个模范的带头作用。
No matter for the movements or the spirits, we all have to be the samples for people.
哎，那我接下来我就开始勒头啊。
Okay, Master Yu, you're gonna have to put headdress on.
京剧每一个剧目就是一个故事。
A different Peking Opera show will just tell a different story.
我们有五千年的文化，我们有着悠久的历史，所以我们有很多值得我们这个后人们学习和颂扬的我们的这种传统美德。尤其是我们的传统艺术作品
especially our traditional plays.
绝大部分内容都是颂扬着中华优秀传统美德
most stories are turning the positive side.
弘扬的真善美
To tell people like how to act and be a better person for themselves.
忠孝仁爱、仁义礼智信，在我们传统剧目当中有很好的诠释。
Be loyal and be nice to your parents, be nice to your friends. These are the spirits we want to pass to the audience and the next generations.
所以我说，我们的青年一代希望他们能够更多的走进剧场，了解我们的民族艺术，了解我们的传统文化。
We hope that more and more young people would walk into the theater to see our traditional show.
观看京剧，欣赏京剧，不仅仅能够得到艺术上的享受，同时也对于青少年，对于我们的后人会有很好的启发和教育。
The spirit and the art side of the Peking Opera also, all the movement and all the spirits we tell would guide people along.
我们很多这个外国朋友对我们的中国文化并不了解，啊，对我们的这个中国的这个新的这种时代生活人们的精神面貌并不了解，但是。当我们走出去，通过观看我们的演出，通过我们的到访，他们了解了中国文化，了解了中国艺术的魅力。
People in other countries don't really know the culture of China, but once we get outside to perform for them, and they would tell our cultures by the Peking Opera.
同时也通过我们的这个表演，也要通过我们的精神面貌。了解了新时代啊，当代中国人的这种精神面貌和我们的生活状态。
And also, they can chill the spirits in our legislation like through our performing.
所以我们经常呢，经常说，不仅仅要给我们自己传播文化作为一个很好的一个传承工作，我们也把我们定位在一个我们这个中华优秀文化的一个传播使者。
Not only like the actors and actresses, we are actually passing down the culture.
用京剧艺术这样一个独特的，也是最具代表性的一个传播的载体，向世界讲述我们中国的故事。
Using Peking Opera, the special show of China to tell our stories and our spirits to the whole world.
也借此机会特别感谢啊，央视海外频道、央视频以及快手等等这些新媒体的这些平台，台前幕后的这些工作人员对于我们京剧艺术的宣传和支持。
And thanks to all the different programs and media to help us.
希望今后能够有更多的机会来宣传我们的国粹，宣传中国的京剧。好，在这里衷心的祝福大家。
Give your best wishes.
再见。
Bye. See you next time.